Our guest today on Let's Talk is Starr Taylor. And Starr is not only a member of the Arkansas State University basketball team, but she is, I guess, the president or co-president of the Power of One or Two, which is a nonprofit organization. First of all, welcome to our show, Starr.
Thank you for having me.
And tell us a little bit, we'll get into some basketball talk later because I've got a lot of basketball questions. But I want to know about the Power of One or Two.
Well, the Power of One or Two Incorporated is a nonprofit organization that I co-founded with my brother, Blaze Taylor. He's actually the president, I'm the vice president, so. but both of us play the same role in it. A nonprofit is kind of founded on the triple E effect. We aim to empower, enhance, and educate the lives of children and at-risk youth. So it's more geared toward children.
Enhance, empower,
and educate.
And educate.
Yes, sir.
So that's fabulous. Tell me how you came up with it, and tell me where it takes place.
Well, people always kind of think that it's going to have like a elaborate like story behind it, but really, last summer Blaze and I were watching the news, and a local church did a school supply drive. And we're like, that's really awesome how like the community came together and everyone like really helped out and gave what they could. And we were kind of joking at first. And we're like, you know, we could do that. Like, that's not anything that's super hard. We could probably do that. And then the talk kind of came into action because then we were like, no, we really could do it. And so we kind of like talked to our parents about it. And I don't think they thought we were really serious. But then we started Googling stuff, trying to figure out what documentation and all the things you needed to become a nonprofit and to be 501c3 certified. And so then we kind of just made it happen. So
that's really cool. And tell me some of the things you've done.
Our very first event, we partnered with A State Care is actually ran by my mom, Dr. Taylor, and she's a teacher in the social work department at Arkansas State University. And they're a group of social work students that just look for needs in the community and try to fulfill them. So they did a fall fest, and they had like blow-ups and food and just like a bunch of games and stuff. And so our first event, we partnered with them to do that. And then we kind of got the hang of things and saw how, you know, planning events works, because it's a lot harder than we thought it was. So then after that, we did Thanksgiving baskets. So we made 20 baskets filled with like turkey and ham and green beans and just Thanksgiving foods. And we delivered them to families and community that were in need of them. We also had a Thanksgiving dinner to feed the community, and we fed over 50 families. So that was really nice and cool to see the turnout of people that actually came to that. We also did a Adopt a Child for Christmas, and we got over 120 presents for children. I think there was 34 or 35 children, and we told them they could put whatever they wanted on their wish list. And it was really kind of amazing to see, though, because some of the kids, like I know when I was little, I would ask for like the most expensive thing, because, you know.
Of course.
And some of these kids like just ask for like a blanket or like clothes or, you know, a new toothbrush and stuff like that. So it was kind of eye-opening to see, and it kind of like humbled me and my brother in a sense of like, wow, like there's people in the community that really need help, and they're asking for like a t-shirt for Christmas or a new pair of jeans. So that was kind of eye-opening in itself. We also did a school supply drive recently, which is kind of ironic because we're kind of like, hey, this is kind of the event that kind of kickstarted, you know, everything into motion. So, yeah.
And so did you have backpacks? Did you have them filled? Or what did
yes,
you do?
We filled 20 backpacks with school supplies. So like folders and markers and colored pencils and just anything that we could think of. And we donated it to Word Baptist Church. And so they're going to distribute it to children in need.
Very nice. What's your next project? Do you have it yet planned yet?
Not yet. We know we're going to have another fall fest. Well, we actually do. We have, it's kind of a surprise, so we can't put it out yet. But if you watch our social media pages, the surprise will be, I guess, let out on Friday. But we also do have two scholarships going on right now. The deadline for them is August 10th. One's a freshman scholarship, and then the other one is a upperclassman, so sophomore, junior, senior. It's real simple. They just have to go to our website, thepowerofoneor2.com, and they just fill out the application and for a chance to win a $500 scholarship. So.
Wow, very nice. Now, how do you raise your money? Do you tell me about some of your fundraising?
Really, it's really just been the community. We've been able to do all of our events or programs through the community's help, whether it be through volunteers or prayers or just donations. Our website has a donate button at the top through PayPal, where people in the community have donated, and the community's just really been great.
Very cool. Tell us the address, the web address.
Oh, it's www.powerofoneortwo.com.
Power of one or two, the numeral one?
Just the number one,
yeah,
or two.
Yeah, well, power of one or two dot com?
Yes.
Okay, dot com, power of one or two dot com. So you're doing this, and now your family is, you're all in at ASA.
Oh, yes.
Is your brother in college too?
My brother actually graduated. He's at Duke now. He's a GA for Duke football.
Oh, is that right?
So he's gone from Arkansas State now, but he did play football here. And then my dad's a football coach at Arkansas State. And then my mom's a professor in the social work program. And then I'm on the basketball team. So we're all in at A-State. We're committed.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. I think feel like we all should be that far in. Now, your dad is Trooper Taylor.
Yes, sir.
And he is a football coach, and you recognize him because his hat's backwards.
Yes.
And that's a tribute to his father.
Yes, sir.
And he's a motivational speaker. Are you looking to go along those lines, too?
Not necessarily in the motivational speaking. I'm kind of more laid back and shy. If you know my dad, you know he's not shy at all.
He's
the complete opposite of shy. But what my dad has taught me and my brother, we grew up in seven different states, so we moved around a lot. So
coaches kids.
Yes. So he definitely taught us the importance of being in a community, though, even though we were always moving to different communities. But he also showed us the impact of leaving a place better than you found it, because that was something that his dad told us. So even though I never met my grandpa, that's something that I always have in my mind, whether it just be picking up trash when you're outside, if you see something, just always leave a place better than you found it. So being around my dad coaching, the athletes always have to do community service and stuff. So community service has always been like a big part of me and my brother's life. That, and then my mom being a social worker, so you know, she's really big on community service as well. So
leave a place better than you found it. That's really kind of profound, you know, because we can all do that at some level.
Yes, sir.
And that always kind of sticks in your mind. It's something that you guys talk about at the, you've had it ingrained.
All the time. Yes. And that's actually kind of where we got our name from. I know it's kind of a spinoff too, because my brother was actually number one. His jersey number was number one, and I'm
okay.
Number two.
Okay.
So a lot of people are like, oh, it's because of your jersey numbers, which in a sense, yes, but it's also going back to leaving a place better than you found it. There's a verse, 1 Peter 4:10, and that's what our nonprofit's kind of founded on, and it says each of you has been given one of God's many wonderful gifts to be used in the service of others, so use your gift well. So in essence, the Power of One or Two is mainly all about, it only takes one or two to make a difference. You don't have to be super rich, you don't have to be somebody famous, you don't have to be in a large group. You yourself can make an impact on someone's life. And if you make an impact on someone's life, they'll impact somebody else, and the butterfly effect will just take place, and then you can impact 20 to 100 people and not even know it. So
yeah, that's a fabulous message, and that's inspiration. I think it's good to see our young people lead it, because you've just inspired me a little bit.
Thank you.
So tell me, what year are you in school?
I'm a senior in the classroom, but I'm a junior on the court.
A junior on the court.
Yes, sir.
All right, so you've got two seasons left.
Yes, sir.
How's Arkansas State stacking up this year?
Oh, we have a really good freshman class, and we have we only lost two seniors. So since I've been here, we've kind of been a young team, because my class came in with seven freshmen. So, we've been kind of a younger team. Yes, sir. It's been a lot of growing experience, but I feel like we're going to be pretty good this year. Our freshman class is really good. They've done a great job of catching up on things that maybe took my class or the class previous a little longer to pick up on. And then our upperclassmen this year, we've really grown into like leaders, and I feel like it's just going to be a good season this year.
Very good, very good. So I guess between sports and school and church, that's the talk around the house is covered.
Pretty much.
Stuff.
Yes, sir.
That's great. That's great. Well, Starr, it's fabulous to have you on Let's Talk Jonesboro, and all the congrats I can give to your organization. Tell people again how they can donate to it or be a part of some of the things you guys do.
You can go to our website, www.thepowerofone2.com, to donate or to just catch up on any of our events. We have videos or pictures of all the events we've done thus far. You can also donate there on the tab. It's under the donate tab. And also, you can email us at powerofone2@gmail.com if you have any concerns in the community or any events or programs that you would like us to sponsor or help you with as well.
And I'll take from her inspiration and say, do what you can today to leave Jonesboro better than you found it. I know I'm going to. Thank you.
Thank you.